not come across any such accidents, as I would call it. So, but I do have people who are very close to me who have. So yes, you know, we say that people should come up with something for the safety of women. And Femina indeed has come up with this app. So I think the first thing that each woman needs to do is download this app and, you know, help keep our country safe.
Thank you, Gail.
Thank you.
Hey, Tanya, Femina has been this lifestyle and go-to guide for me, right from when I've been 14 or 15 years old, when my mom used to subscribe to Femina, and now I do. And so it's very apt that a magazine like this, that is not just a glamour magazine, it just covers everything, covers so many age groups. It has taken the onus of coming to our rescue with the Femina to Your Rescue app. There are lots of apps that have come out for women's safety, but I think the special features that your app has is the fact that you're armed with information. A lot of apps don't have that kind of information. The articles that you cover in your magazine will be available to you in terms of defense moves, in terms of rape laws, in terms of legalities, step by step, exactly. How to actually register an FIR. So these are, you know, armed with information, you are so much more powerful. So that is one thing that I think is very special with your app, and the fact that there's that siren. Also, the ease with which you can alert your contacts, because, you know, if you have to get into, if you unlock your phone and get into the app, by the time you've gotten into the app, you wasted a lot of time. So if you just, even if you have your phone in your hand and you press the power button three times, without anybody around you even knowing it, I think that's of prime importance, being able to reach your emergency contacts without actually wasting a lot of time. Yeah, you're already jittery. The fact is you can press that button three times and get to your contacts and get to the police. So I think your app has some very special features. And I thank you and, of course, the Mumbai Police for coming up with this initiative and making us feel all the more safe. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Madhara. Thank you so much. Ms. Asmita Tikhavka, a few words from your end, please.
Good morning to all dignitaries. In that sense, I am always to our main motto is road safety. And when passengers are traveling in the public transport, then women, 30% women use public transport in the Mumbai city. It is very important to introduce such apps in the public transport, so we can also take some steps to improve this system. In that sense, we are introducing the program for encouraging more and more women who are coming in this transport, bus drivers, taxi drivers, and other rickshaw drivers in this profession. So, women phone fleet taxi scheme has been introduced by our department, which is inserting rule 66A in this motor vehicle rules, and only women operated Priyadarshini taxi scheme service fleet taxis of 35 vehicles has been given stands for prepaid taxi in the international and domestic airports also. Vira cabs in taxi service, which is operated only by women drivers, taxi and is engaged in the duties in the domestic airport also. As per the Mumbai Metropolitan Road Transport Authority, that is MMRTA, also introduced the new decision, that is in July of 2015, the direction that the women auto rickshaws drivers shall address women passengers and their family members on priority, to allow only male passengers to board who auto rickshaw driven by women drivers in the decision of the women auto rickshaw drivers. Women who are interested to participate in this program can drive an auto rickshaw whose permit holder is a male, with a note on the vehicle stating that priority for women's passengers. And we can take measures on encouraging women drivers also, providing new vehicles for the scheme on sponsorship of 95 taxis and 230 auto rickshaws, women lottery schemes also, providing mediclaim policy as well as insurance policy for women drivers, providing special education scheme for children of women drivers and for women drivers.
We took one step ahead, and 7 months back we started adding extra layer of GPS in the vehicle that in the case in this situation, where if a driver throws the mobile or if he's not traceable, his vehicle will always be traceable and, you know, anybody can reach to that specific transport vehicle. We are really happy that, you know, the Femina app, so that the safety that is available, the concept of, you know.
Besides saying that it's a pleasure being here, it is also an eye-opener that you, the media, the press, is taking such a responsible position, but not just the app, but letting people know about how to save themselves. This app is brilliant. Brilliant why? At the touch of a button, I feel safe, I feel protected. And most of all, as a doctor, I have seen traumatized women and children in my practice, I've treated them. But come what may, they would not make a formal complaint anywhere against their perpetrator, against their abuser. This has become my pet peeve. And with this app, we are assured anonymity, which is the best part about this app. Only people concerned will know about my trouble. I don't have to go to the police station to file an FIR. They come to me. I can in some small way save face that I'm the one who has been victimized for no fault of mine. Even today, women take it as their fault, although they are not at fault, they are just the victims. And I'm happy that we have this app, and sure, it's brilliant. Thank you.
Thank you all. I'd like to thank all my panel members for demonstrating this commitment.
Some of few safety precautionary guidelines. Do not talk to strangers. Do not take a ride with strangers. Do not accept gifts from strangers, even if they are daddy's friends. Should teach them difference between good touch and bad touch. I've been to Priyanka's school, and I was kind of a counselor in their school, my son's school, and I was given this responsibility. I used to have this talk with the children and the parents that you only can indoctrinate your children. You can't tell a guy, once he's already developed this nonsense, to change, or a girl to change. It's very difficult to start young before their brains have been damaged by the bad internet content, by the bad abusive things. And most importantly, what I was saying is the women should be given the power, the strength to believe that they will not be uprooted out of their own homes because they are victims. I will not put a woman into a remand house. I will not put my child into a foster home. I will get the perpetrator, the abuser, out of the house. He is the one who needs treatment. He is the one who needs help. I would take the man off from his comfortable zone, be it an employer, be it a husband, be it a brother, be it a father-in-law, mother-in-law, whoever. They should be removed from their dignified, comfortable position and sent, at least get psychiatric evaluation and help. They are mentally ill. You put them with criminals, like criminals, they come out hardened, worse, and they become rapists and murderers. We should stop before it goes to this point. And it's never too late to start. We should start today, now, with our children. Maybe 10 years, 15 years down the line, we would be able to make a difference. And I think every citizen is your moral responsibility, not just to look after your own house, but to look after everyone in your neighborhood. Suppose you see your neighbor, the woman in the neighboring house, being victimized. She will never come forward and make a complaint against her husband because she's not sure how it will be taken with. The stigma, will she be thrown out of the house, all those things. So the police, I would request, should take cognizance of a non-family member's complaint and keep that family under observation at least. So suppose there's a repeat offense, then you should pick that person out. Not let innocent people be damaged, and then it is too late. So this is what has been my job. Thank you.
That was really helpful. Thank you so much, and thank you, ladies. Any more questions? For a nice photo, please.